Hello, I'm Mr. Arnachar, a retired lecturer in metallurgy. I'm a scientist and I teach Christianity, Sikhism and real Islam, which is Sharia free. The second coming of Jesus took place in India in the name of Nanak. And over there the people among whom Nanak took his birth, they were the kings and emperors of darkness, are most satanic people you can come across in the world. People of Judah tribe were just princes, and when Jesus rebuked Judah Iscariot that he was supposed to die, but you became a medium and you should not have been born, he killed himself when the 30 shekel become blood money and give it to the temple. They won't accept it. And he threw it into the temple of Yahweh, the potter. So they bought it by a potter's field. But in India, they don't care. So far the money comes. Where from come, it doesn't matter. The blood money or no blood money. Greediest people you can come across. So that's why in India there was a lot of religious trouble, fanaticism, and there are four communities, and the last two communities is of apostles and philanthropic soldiers. They both were formed in India. They use sword power. Not just the word of mouth was not enough for them. So the people to whom this dark age belongs, they are people of Judah tribe in the Middle East. At the time of King David, they were very good people, honest people. And that's why one woman, when she saw the benevolent works of Jesus, she said, you are real son of David. You are in his footsteps. But not the other one, crook one. They killed him. Same in India. In the time of Ramchandra, the people of Khatri tribe, they were angelic, very good people. And very well versed in the religious verses, books. And in this dark age, they misuse them, that knowledge. They are very clever and opportunist, and they know how to exploit the people. So for the sake of money, they became Mohammedan and then killed many people. So, as in the Middle East, when the prophets came, the local people, they killed them, maltreated them. But when the people from overseas started to reverend them, give them reverence, then they built big, big temples in their names to make a business out of the name for the sake of money. And same in India, when the Satguru Nanak Dev Ji was there and his life, they were the staunch enemy of Sikhism. Less than 0.7% turned to Nanak. I belong to the Jatt tribe. We are village people. Jatt. We were the maximum, 65 to 70%, we turned to Sikhism. And then the other, you know, village tribes, they turned to Sikhism. But the least, they were the from the towns where they were cheating and all that. So this Manmohan Singh, Lala, he is a Lala. Lala means the shopkeeper. All those people who do shopkeeping, their Katshi title is Lala. And same of Nanak. Nanak, he was a Lala too. So this Lala Manmohan Singh, Kohli Khatri, although he has done a good work too, but his nature, cleverness, opportunist, how to cut through the people, that nature, it never moves. So here I have written something, and most of the people from India, they know, but they forget those things very easily. How these Khatris, when they turned mullah in the mosque, and how atrocities, what atrocities they committed, they forget. And the fifth light of Nanak, Satguru Arjan Dev Ji, he was put on a hot iron plate for 4 days by a Chandu Sodhi Khatri, Lala Chandu Sodhi Khatri. He was the administrator of Lahore. And then the royal king Har Gobind Ji, he got him through friendship with the king, emperor, so he got him caught and gave him a right punishment for all the cruel thing he did. Then at the time of Aurangzeb, the Satguru Tegh Bahadur Ji, who was the sixth Satguru. There are six Satguru, 4 royal kings. So he was killed by the Khatris who turned mullahs of Kashmir, and they committed very too many atrocities. They will tell the people, open the mouth, I want to fish. They had no morality at all. And they killed them, Kashmiri Khatris. And today they are repaying what they did in the past. So the end of the age is next year, on 14 May 2023, when Israel is 75 years old. Chosen people, they are the demonstration nation of the world. Through them we learn all the moral laws. So I put many videos on that topic. Let's carry on with this one. In India, the politics is happening, that this Jatt, you know, who is Navjot Sidhu, Chaudhary Navjot Sidhu Jatt. He is no wiser than ordinary person. He is honest, you know, there is no doubt, but not wiser. So he is going and kissing the feet of this Lala, Manmohan Singh, Kohli Khatri, and it is a shame for him, because we Jatts have nothing to hide or to be ashamed of. So after so much enmity against the 10 lights, could you trust a Khatri, Lala Manmohan Singh Kohli Khatri? Lala Manmohan Singh Kohli. Lala Nanak Dev Ji, born of the Mehta Khatri Kalu. Kalu means that he is, his heart is black. Black is not shining like silver, but it is black. Black means full of greed, greedy one. We call it DILL DAA KALA LOBHI. He loved money. And remember when he gave 40 rupees to Nanak to go and start business. And Nanak went to buy the things, took with him the village people, and he met sadhus. So he gave them a hearty feast out of those 40 rupees, made them happy. And that greed money was turned into white money by Nanak, by giving it, feeding the poor. But when he returned to home, this Kalu, he was angry that he has spent all the money on sadhus, given to them. And he slapped him. So this Rajput Bhatti, who was the village head, he knew Nanak. He loved Nanak. So when Kalu slapped Nanak, then Rajput Bhatti told his wife, go bring 40 rupees and give it to this Kalu. So she gave it to Kalu. And also Rajput Bhatti gave half of his land, half belongs to wife, half his own, to Nanak as donation. And Nanak did not eat a small amount of that for evil. When he wanted to settle, he settled at Kartarpur, different place, and bought his own land of his money. That means, in religion, people who bring donations, you should not rely upon that. You should work hard, as Saint Paul was making a tent maker, earning his own living, not a parasite. These in the churches, those who are hiring doctor or priest, at the end of the month they earn salary. They are not working for God, they are working for mammon. And they are like Judas Iscariot, who was holding the purse. Whenever he wanted money, he would steal money from the purse. That is, these in the churches today, these hireling doctors, priests, they are thieves of the order of Judas Iscariot. So that's why Jesus threw him away at the Last Supper, before he took the 11 into the house of our supernatural Father, where he washed their feet and entertained them and performed the marriage ceremony, which is Eucharist. So, in India, you know, the things were terrible. No conscience. And here are something written for the what is happening now. Their nature doesn't change. So when Nanak was alive, less than least of all turned to Sikhism. They were all very arrogant that we have the knowledge of the Vedas. We can recite this and that. And their parents would tell them, all that one, they recite it in Sanskrit. So, there's so much enmity against the 10 lights. Could you trust a Khatri, Lala Manmohan Singh KOHLI? Remember that the last Khwajas are very clever people. They are Khatris from Kashmir. And it was the Khwaja who led the forces against Sache Pasha, royal king Gobind Singh Ji, and uprooted him from Anandpur and caused all that suffering. So all these things are well known to the people of Sikh community, and you should read or watch my other videos to relate to tell you. So they are the most unreliable people, Khatri tribe, as people of Judah tribe in the Middle East. Lala Nanak Dev Ji, born of the Mehta Khatri Kalu. Kalu means dark colored. His heart was dark colored.
Okay, thank you, brother.
So, Kalu means dark colored, because he was a greedy person. And for money, he won't part with it. Very greedy. And Nanak spent 40 rupees to entertain sadhus. His greed money was transferred into white money. But when he returned home, they beat him, as I told you before. So, very well versed in the Vedas. They are very well versed in the Vedas, better than the Brahmin, people born of the Brahmin tribes. Did not honor Satguru Nanak Dev Ji. He himself did not honor Satguru Nanak Dev, but a stupid Jatt, RAI BHULLAAR, Bhatti, Kaum Jatt. Now his Kaum was Jatt and not Rajput, who was misled by the greedy Brahmins, greedy by Brahmin, the sycophant, to get more money from him. Hey, you are the son of kings, Maharajas. The other poor people, you know, they are Jatput. You are Rajput. So they give them this sycophant's title, Rajput, and calling the ordinary people Jatput as they were, making them to forget their own tribal identity. They themselves don't know their own tribal identity, and they won't let their other people know tribal identity. How can a blind guide can give light to the other? No way. So identity too was misled by the greedy Brahmins and changed his tribal identity to Rajput, the son of a Rajah. But Raja is an office. When one Raja defeats the other, then the other Raja, who is a winner, take over the throne of the defeated Raja. It changes, office change. A Raja has public, you know, which is called REEYATT, to rule over, and that is why he was given the name RAI BHULLAAR. RAI means king, and BHULLAAR means the one who is misled or has forgotten. RAI means the king of the spiritually blind people. But he was the first to highly honor Nanak as Budhoo Shah. And Budhoo Shah, who gave all his four sons to Royal King Gobind Singh Ji to help fight the terrorist or unrighteous people. And when they died, four of them, then Royal King Gobind Singh Ji, Sache Paasha Gobind Singh Ji, he asked Budhoo Shah, Peer Budhoo Shah, what would you like, ask for it. Then at that time, Sache Paasha Gobind Singh Ji, he was combing his hair. He said, "Your comb with hair, that's how you work." Now the comb is on the head, highly honored, and hair are also honored. So by the name, he is the greatest stupid man. Shah means greatest stupid man. But he got the wisest prize, the comb with hair intact, the greatest spiritual honor he got. Thus the greatest of three moral teachers called gurus. Now the moral teachers teach you the letters, book. But the spiritual preacher, they don't bring you book. They explain to you through verbal to the very deep root. And those who are predestined and not used to book knowledge, they will get it. So the village people, they appreciated the saying of Nanak, but not the town people who were book people. They loved Quran and Vedas and other things, arguing with each other. So there are three moral teachers, which is mother, give you social education, father, how to earn your living, economical, and Brahmin is a political affair, how to deal in political affair. The three bound by the three knots of Janu. They have a thread, you know, of this one, and it at the end it has a three knots. Those three knots represent these three teachers, mother, father, and Brahman Guru. You know, why is the fourth is Satguru, who preaches gospel to your man, mind, or nafs, same thing. The one who teaches to your, this is the mind here, which is a nafs also. This is buddhi, and this is ego at the back. So the buddhi is in the middle here. It is a knot to it, not meant to remind you that above those three that are locked in the janu, there is one of this living temple of God, which is Satguru. So that knot is of Satguru to the Bodhi. So that was what Nanak was. Satguru Nanak, and same as Christ Jesus, same thing. Both gave us the spiritual knowledge. Nanak was the second coming of Jesus. And this golden temple is of the same size as the holiest of holy used to be in Jerusalem and now is in Mosque Al-Aqsa under there. Many things I can tell more. Let's concentrate on this small one, not to the Bodhi. These Khatris have misled the people. Now some sincere ones want to know Christ Nanak. They cannot know him. These Khatris, they used to mislead the people for the sake of money, give them sugar-coated sermon. As when the last Satguru, Christ, Tegh Bahadur Ji, was to appear in that village, 22 imposter Khatris, they opened their shop that I am the next one, I am the next one. That means at that time, not many people were enlightened, even though it was highly enlightened era. So this knowledge is one in a million in India, or one in a thousand and two in 10,000. So when the real one was outdoor by a Lubana of Lubana tribe, who was a businessman and whose ship he had saved from sinking. And he said, when I reach the land safe and sound, I will give 500 golden coins to Nanak house. So when the ship was safe and sound reached soil, and he took his brethren with him in search of Nanak's survival. So they keep on finding who is the next one. And when they were told that it is in Baba Bakale, Baba means grandfather in Bakale. So he reached that village and he found there are 22 people claiming to be, they are the one, they are the one. So what he did, he put one golden coin in front of each. Okay. So none of them asked for more. And then he asked the people, local people, is there another grandfather, Baba? Yes, there is one called Tega, and he is always meditating. Then he went to his house, and after honoring him, he put one in front of him. Then Satguru Tegh Bahadur Ji said, you did not promise one, you promised 500. And then he showed him his back. Well, look, I was pulling your ship, and here are the marks of the rope. Then he laid everything over there and went on the rooftop to tell people, I have found him, I have found him. So when they have found him, those imposter Khatris were not frightened. They got together. Remember that if the people who are cheating, robbers, if they don't unite together, their kingdom will fall. So those 22 imposters, they united together to fight against Satguru Tegh Bahadur Ji. He was the last on earth Christ. And when he was being outdoor, they hired a gunman to kill him. The gunman fired, but it just passed through the, near the arm, not hurting him much. So, Makhan Shalomana was, and his workers, they were not happy to see this one. They bring that culprit and the Khatris who hired him in front of Satguru Tegh Bahadur Ji. Satguru Tegh Bahadur Ji under Bhakti Marg. Bhakti Marg means we have no enemy or stranger because we are one father. We are all brethren, whether we are good or bad. No hatred. So he told them, no, no, don't harm them. Let them go. So they let them go. And after that one, he went to Amritsar to pay homage to the house of Nanak. And when he reached Amritsar, the Khatris, they closed the door. They won't let him enter. So he sat outside and told the people, Khatri, andar sadiye. That means the Khatri Amritsariye, Andar Sariye. The people of Amritsar are the most crook people. And that is what they are today. Worse than those, the thugs of Banaras were used to go to put the ashes of the people and also to get their record, put there that whose son has died and this and that. So you can get all this family tree from them. So these Khatris have misled the people, and now some sincere ones want to know Christ Nanak. They cannot know him. They still address Satguru Nanak, a guru, a moral teacher, a degrading, addressing royal king, Sache Pasha Gobind Singh Ji, a guru, is very highly dishonoring him. So much so that they called the terrorist, so much though they are called the terrorist Bhindranwalla. Bhindranwalla recently occupied the this holiest of holy complex in the world, here Amritsar, with gun. But remember that the Sikh has no enemy or stranger. So with carrying gun, he wasn't a Sikh. And carrying these weapons over there, when royal king Sache Pasha Gobind Singh Ji never visited this complex because Khalsa fighter, they are not compatible with this place. This place is for the Sikh Bhaktan, student of spiritual knowledge, and Nirmale Santan. Nirmale Santan means the apostles. Apostles don't use a double-edged sword of khanda of steel, but double-edged sword of his word. So, royal kings, Sache Pasha, Gobind Singh Ji, they were nothing compatible with him. So he did not enter this place. So what the hell this Bhindranwalla doing there? He wasn't a Khalsa either. He was a terrorist. And look what damage he has got it done. But they call Khatri promote him as a saint. They are the first one, you know, to praise anybody. They want opportunist. If they see the thing going the wrong direction, and where there is a money, oh, they are number one to praise and everything. For greater detail, watch my over 8,000 videos on YouTube. It is hard. They are so misled, you know, that when they start, you know, in the Gurdwaras and other places, they start Ekam Kaar, which is wrong. It is Har Aikum Kaar. Har Aikum Kaar from Hari Om Shanti. So if they know Hari Om Shanti, then they will know Har Aikum Kaar. And they say Aikum Kaar, or they have no knowledge of Har and Hari. So much so that this temple, in Golden Temple, is Harmandir. Harmandir Sahib, temple of God. And some educated people, they call it a Harimandir. Harimandir means a temple of Hindus, of Brahma. Brahma, this is a temple of our Brahmin on this side. So, they don't know. And one of my Jatt brother, he is a Virk, very highly educated. And I wrote to him and he said, oh, you don't have any knowledge of Sikhism. You maybe have knowledge of Christianity, but not of Sikhism. And he writes Harimandir. So such is our Jatt people, that with little knowledge, a little thing, which the other people do, they just copy them and they become Gyani. And these Khatris will listen to them, not me. This Lala can't sing Nabba. This is another very Satanic Khatri, dangerous. Nabba. Nabba's book, which is Mahakosh. He wrote a book, We Are Not Hindus, cuts the very roots of Sikhism. The root of the Sikhism is in Hinduism. A Hindu is one who knows his own, a tribal identity. If a stranger comes to a village, then people ask him, who are you? Then in reply he will say, I come from this village and my tribe is this, Jati or Basi. This is called Bond, identity, tribal identity. He is a Hindu. This haircut and denoun does not make you a Hindu. I am a Hindu. So if I'm not son of man, I cannot be son of God. So, Hindu makes you son of man. And these people, this Lala, can't sing. Nabba. Nabba is a state that he was born of a prostitute who served the whole Nabba state. And he was born of her. She could not give any other surname, but that of the mother Nabba. And some people in India put the, like Badal, Caro, all the put the village name. So their mother went all the village, and they were the born, and When the son was born, mother could not say which, who is the father of this one, but the whole village. And this Jatt Thaliwal, which is Barnala, he put the name of the big, big town, Barnala, that his mother was a good, healthy, well-known, famous prostitute of Barnala, and he was born out of that birth. So that's the, how stupid are our Jatts. Now, these Khatri, they don't put the name of the village, they put their own son name. They just have the other people, oh, the gurus have arranged all this caste system. They haven't arranged caste system, they didn't marry anybody outside the Khatri tribe. So, Har Aikum Kaar from the Hari Om Shanti, and they are, and they say Aikum Kaar, or they have no knowledge of Har and Hari. This Lala Khan Singh Nabba book, that we are not Hindus, touched the very roots of Sikhism. The roots of the Sikhism are cut, then the tree of Sikhism will dry away. Hindu is the first Panth and Sikh the second Panth. How could you be a Sikh without being a Hindu? The son of man, of Brahm Kaa Baetta. So, use your common sense. This knowledge is not in the books. This knowledge, you get it when you are capable of intuition. It's here, not in the books. So, that is why Bhakti Kripa say, Jo Brahm Mande, so he pinned it. Brahm Mande means the people, you know, when they want to learn spiritual knowledge, they go from, hey, let me go, that sadhu, this sadhu, that sadhu. They visit him, you know. And they will say, what sadhu has told them, say, without understanding. So Bhakti Kripa said, if you are capable of self-realization or intuition, all is here. You don't need to go anywhere. Interpretation of the Bani also comes to those who are sincere. And the other, you know, can just do what the other people blindly. So let's see, Panth say, the second is, how could you be a Sikh without being a Hindu, the son of man, Brahm Kaa Baetta. Brahm Kaa Baetta, Brahm ke Baetta, Shabd Paehshhaataa. He will understand his word. So many videos are made, but this is all by the grace of our supernatural Father. Nobody can have it unless you desire it from the core of your heart, and then you will get it. So people will call you fool because it is not written in ink on paper anywhere else. So they will say, oh, this man have no knowledge. But our Father God blesses everyone.